Hello everyone and welcome to our webinar today. The topic of today's webinar is the education edition of PERMAS. This is a joint presentation with my colleague Michael Klein. First of all, I would like to thank my colleagues from the development department for their work. Without them, the PERMAS for Education edition wouldn't exist. When I started working at INTIS 9 years ago, I already had the wish for a free version of PERMAS and BISPA. It's finally happened. We are here to show you our latest achievements. What you can expect today can be seen in the overview. In the first part, I will start with a short introduction. What is PERMAS for Education? I will talk about the contents of the EDU edition, and then we will continue with limits, rules, and basics. In the second part, we will talk about how to get the education edition. Registration, download, installation, manuals, forum, etc. will be discussed. In the last part, demonstration will be presented that contains a presentation of the PERMAS Control Center, how to launch PERMAS. I will show you how to start Whisper. We will shortly introduce the wizard concept and so on. So first of all, what is PERMAS for Education? PERMAS for Education is essentially the same functionality as PERMAS. However, we have some limitations to prevent commercial use. We will talk about the limits on the next slide. And beside PERMAS, we will offer Whisper, our graphical user interface to PERMAS. This is the pre and post processor that offers you best support with respect to PERMAS. What are your benefits? PERMAS for Education is available on Windows and Linux. It is based on version 18. That means that you have the recent developments over the last 2 years included in the education edition. Almost all modules are available. That means that the education edition is ideal for self-study and further training. You will have access to reference manuals and a multitude of application examples, which you may be known from the examples manual. Of course, you can try out new modules, for example, topology optimization and shape optimization. Furthermore, we offer interfaces to Abacus and Nastran for a seamless transition to PERMAS. Moreover, we offer an enhanced Python interpreter called PyIntis. And for your support and exchange of ideas, we offer user forums hosted at INTIS and ResearchGate. So there are some limitations to prevent commercial use. So the maximum number of nodes is limited to 16,000. The maximum number of degrees of freedom is approximately 65,000. The maximum number of elements is 32,000. And the maximum number of point and line elements, for example, beams, spring elements, mass elements, is restricted to 100. The maximum number of excitation frequencies is equal to 500. The maximum number of time steps is 1,000. The maximum number of load cases is 1,000. And the maximum number of nonlinear result steps is also 100. It is a matter of fact that Python has become the programming language of choice for certain research and industry projects. We are aware of this development and offer an own Python environment. You can use this Python interpreter directly in your UCI inside the user section by using tool 6, where you can launch our Python interpreter with a Python script. You will find some examples illustrating the usage of our Python interpreter. For example, EMA1, that is an experimental model analysis to compute the model assumptions criterion, so the MAG matrix. Furthermore, an Excel export is included in the Python script. An additional example is MNL17, that is a fiber-reinforced wheel where PyIntis is used. Our Python interpreter contains several additional modules, such as NumPy, which is basically provides arrays, linear algebra modules, SciPy. SciPy is an extension of NumPy. Interpolation, optimization, numerical integration, signal processing is included in SciPy. SymPy is a symbolic mathematical module. Matplotlib is basically used for visualization of two-dimensional and three-dimensional graphs that is used in Permas graph. Scikit-Image is used for pattern recognition. For example, you can identify nodal lines from a vibration analysis. MPLL cursors is used for used as a data cursor to annotate curves. Mesh.io is a module to convert several mesh formats, for example, Nastran, Abacus, and Permas. NumPySTL offers an interface to STL files, so you can convert ASCII to binary and vice versa. And for reporting, we offer additional modules such as Python PPTX, Python DocX, and XLS XWriter that generates Excel sheets and many more. You can start PyIntest by using the start menu of Windows. You will find the Miniconda prompt there. The second part is how to get the education edition. That consists of the following points: registration, download, installation, manuals, the user forum, and first usage. So with respect to the registration process, we offer following website where you will find this sheet, and you have some information that you have to share with us. So some mandatory entries, of course, your first name, your last name, and a valid email address. And optional information is your organization, your address, and the country where you're from. And an end user license agreement is available in PDF format. So once you have input your information here, you have to activate the checkbox, I'm not a robot. And then you have to push the send request button. Further instructions will be provided by email, and you will receive a link to the user forum. There are some requirements with respect to the corresponding operating system. So for Windows, we have target CPUs. Supported CPUs are Intel and AMD processors. Only 64-bit operating systems are supported. The build operating system is Windows 10. The target operating system is Windows 10 again. We have a memory limit of 8,000 megabyte and some required Windows packages for opening the documentation. So, for example, PDF viewers like Foxit, Sumatra, and Acrobat Reader are supported. If you want to use Fortran subroutines in your models, you have to install the Intel Fortran compiler on Windows platforms. So the next point is the download and installation on Windows systems. So you have received already an email when you have registered. There are three different executables. The first one is the base installer. The second one contains the Python environment. And the last package contains executables for Permas and Whisper. So you have to copy these executables to one directory, and the received license file should be present in the same directory, so it will be automatically detected when you install the software. So the next point is to run the base installer. So this is the executable, and once you have installed the base installer, you are ready to launch Intis Edu. This is given here on Windows system. You will have an icon on your desktop, and then you can launch the Permas Control Center. So the entire installation process on Windows will be illustrated in this short video. It is a real-time installation process. starting with the base installer. After 13 seconds, you have to confirm the license agreement, and you have to define an installation directory. After that, you are asked for a scratch directory. That should be an SSD disk. The reason is that you have quick access time that improves the performance of your installation. After 1 minute and 48 seconds, you will have a license agreement for the Miniconda environment. And after 6 minutes and 40 seconds, the installation of Permas and Vispa will be more or less completed. So the complete installation is finished after 7 minutes and 20 seconds. I will show you that in a short video. So the first action is to double click on the executable. Then the installation starts. You have to accept the license agreement, installation directory, and the license file, and of course the scratch directory. Once you have defined these settings, the installation process will continue. So I will go forward to 1 minute and 48 seconds. This is the license agreement for the Miniconda environment. And after 6 minutes and 40 seconds, the final part will be installed. That is Permas and Vispa executables. So this is the entire installation process on Windows. The next operating system that is supported is Linux. Again, the target CPUs are Intel and AMD processors. 64-bit operating systems are supported. The build operating system is CentOS 7, and the target operating system is any 64-bit Linux with GNU compiler suite based on glibc 2.18 and the compiler suite E-Fortran, ECC, and E++. Again, we have a memory limit and some requirements for packages like the compilers. And of course, we need some PDF viewer, for example, Ocular, QPDF view, NVINS, or XPDF. So the download installation on Linux is quite similar. Instead of executables, we have shell scripts. And there are three shell scripts, the base installer, the Python environment, and Permas and Vispa executables. So again, you have to copy the license file to the directory containing the downloaded installers. And now you have to run the different installers, beginning with the base installer, and follow the instructions. So the first installer is the base installer. The command in your shell is bash blank Intel base installer. The second one is the Python environment. And the last one is the Permas and Vispa executables. Again, I will show you a short video. in the installation process, you have to specify an installation directory. It's important to define an absolute path. No relative path is accepted here. And the same holds for the license file. Again, you have to specify an absolute path, including the name of the installation or the license file. So we will start with the base installer. Again, you have to confirm the license agreement, the installation directory, the corresponding PDF viewer. So the first base installer is finished. The second one is the Python environment. You have to accept the license again. I will skip some seconds in the installation. It is not as long as the Windows installation. So these are the Python packages that are installed. And the last one is the installation of the executables for Permas and Vispa. and it's finished. So that's very fast on Linux operating systems. The next point is the manuals. I have already mentioned that we offer manuals. So the available manuals for the education edition are listed here. The first one is an introduction, that is PERMAS for Education. You will receive the user's reference manual, that is the same as in the maintenance version, and the examples manual, that is the same as in the maintenance version, and the Whisper user's manual, and of course, some installation manuals for the operating systems, and the tools user's manual that contains information about PERMAS Graph, PERMAS Control Center, and so on. So the next point is the user forum that is mainly introduced for the exchange with other users. The web address is given here, and an additional platform to exchange ideas to create some questions and so on is available on ResearchGate. If you click the PERMAS button in the control center, you will receive this window where you will see the web address for the PERMAS user forum again. And this is our user forum that is hosted at Ingest. It is based on Redmine. So the next point is the first usage. So how to use the installed packages. The central point is our PERMAS Control Center. Here you can specify some settings. For example, you can use Emacs Gold, that is an extension of Emacs for editing PERMAS .dat files. Code handling is supported by automatic highlighting using the pigments highlighter. You will have direct access to manuals on the start page of the PERMAS Control Center. I will show you how to extract examples. We will use the linear statics one example. I will show you how to edit UTI files and using the F1 button to get access to the reference menu. I will start the PERMAS job and I will open the model and results by using Whisper. So these are the main points of the following video. What you can see here on the right hand side is the start page of the PERMAS Control Center. We will start with the Ingest support. So you have access to the user forum, but no hotline support. Settings here, you can specify Emacs Gold as your favorite editor. You can specify the corresponding PDF viewer for the documentation. The documentation is directly available, as mentioned before, so you have access to these reference manuals. The next point is to extract one example by using getExample. So you will see a list of available modules and subsequent examples. We will extract the LS1 example for our working directory. Once you have opened that, UCI file will be opened. Highlighting is supported, and if you press the F1 button in the corresponding line, you will get some additional information about the command that is used in the UCI file. Then this UCI file will be stored again, and then we will launch PERMAS. This is a very short example. Elapsed time is 1 second for the LS1 example. And the next point is to post-process the results. So we will open the HDF file that contains the results. Then we will open Whisper. So this is the trust structure, results and data. Then we will visualize displacements in Scala in deformed representation. So you will see the deformed structure for different load patterns. So as you can see, it is quite easy to get started with PERMAS. So the last part is a demonstration of different topics. PERMAS Control Center, we've already seen that. Again, we will launch PERMAS and Whisper, and I will introduce you to the wizard concept in Whisper. So the standard process of the CAE process is usually that we assume that we have already a mesh given in PERMAS DAT format or geometric information given in STL format or any other supported FEM format like an Abacus input file, Nastran, white data file, or an IDS universal file. So here we will focus on the import of geometry. So we have an STL file that is provided with the education edition of PERMAS. This will be used to introduce the usual process. So the pre-processing, the solver is skipped here, and the post-processing is skipped here. It's just to show you how to import STL files, to remesh these STL files, and to set up a volume mesh. So STL files are basically raw, unstructured, triangulated surface meshes. Currently we support only the ASCII format of STL files. However, you can use our Python environment, it's NumPy STL, to convert binary STL files into ASCII STL files. Regarding the import options, you can directly import STL files in Whisper. Alternatively, you might use read STL file inside your input section of your UCI file. Usually, a remeshing is necessary due to poor element quality. This will be illustrated in the forthcoming video. And the last point is the volume meshing. That is also supported by Whisper by using an interface through NetJet. So the patch meshing and design wizard are the main points of the following video. We will use the Whisper tutorial Edu 1. We will check the element quality. So the triangles will be converted into plot R3 elements for visualization purposes. We will use the patch meshing tool for remeshing. We will use an average edge length of 5 millimeters. Please note that the edges are retained during remeshing. Then we will check again the element quality. You will see that we are able to improve the element quality significantly. And the next point is the design wizard that is used to build a volume mesh. So now I will start the video. The starting point is again the PERMAS Control Center. We will extract the STL file. And then we will start Whisper. So this is just one test example, very small STL file. I will display the edges, so you will see the elements and nodes. The next point is to check the element quality of the entire model. So you will see that there are some issues. Some elements create errors and some create warnings. We have to get rid of these erroneous elements. We will start the patch meshing tool. We will use an average edge length of 5 millimeters, as mentioned before. Then the remeshing takes place. And the new component will be stored in a new component called test. So now you will see the new mesh. The edges, as mentioned before, are retained, and the element quality has significantly improved. So we have no issues. The next point is to launch the design wizard. that is used to create the solid mesh. So now the solid mesh is available, and again I will check the element quality of the tab mesh. We have only warnings. So this is one element that creates a warning that is highlighted here. And the final point is to export the new items so that we have access to the solid mesh for further computations. It is the final point of this short video. And the next one is an example from optimization. We have introduced some new design constraints in optimization for both for topology and shape optimization. We have introduced the buckling constraint, so you can use the design constraint for the load scale factor or the eigenvalue of the buckling eigenvalue problem. The objective of this small example is to minimize the weight subjected to two different constraints from a static analysis and from a buckling analysis. We will use the displacement at the load point in the direction of the load as a design constraint for the static analysis, and we will use the lowest load scale factor from the buckling analysis as an additional design constraint. The model characteristics are given here on the right hand side. It is a cylindrical shell supported at the corner nodes. So the corner nodes are completely clamped. A unit force is applied at the center point of the upper edge. The material that is used is aluminium. The radius of the cylindrical shell is 3 meters. The height is 260 millimeters. The arc length is 520 millimeters, and the thickness of the shell is 2 millimeters. The example is taken from the literature to compare results, of course. On the left-hand side, you will see the UCI file. For those of you that are new to PERMAS, PERMAS is controlled by a stream of commands submitted by the user control interface called UCI. All optimization tasks or all optimization problems are solved in an iterative way. So we have to use a number of loops, and inside the loop, the different analysis types that are connected to the optimization are included. So the static analysis and the buckling analysis. And we want to perform a topology optimization using our favorite method ACP. This is the export section to export the filling ratio, for example. And at the end, we have some additional information regarding the history. So the evolution of the objective function, the evolution of the constraint history, and the evolution of the relative constraint history. All these data can be exported to PERMAS, for example, or to spreadsheet, whatever you prefer. In the subsequent videos, I will show you the following points. Again, we will start with the PERMAS Control Center. I will show you once again how to get examples. We will introduce the model completion process with respect to optimization. I will show you how to export new items. Then we will launch this example, and we will continue with post-processing of topology optimization results. XY data are visualized by using PERMAS graph. So I will show you the evolution of the objective function, the relative constraint history that is used to check if there are any violations of the constraints. And the last point is the evolution of the element filling ratio that is conducted directly in Whisper by a data combination. That is a nice feature that illustrates the evolution of the filling ratio during the optimization. So the first video is about model completion by wizards. The wizard concept in wizard. in Visma is a user-friendly guided way to create additional data. These data are machine-generated. That means that they are less error-prone. In the subsequent steps, I will show you how to create a topology situation, how to create a design element. We will define an initial filling ratio in the topo wizard. We will define lower and upper bounds for the filling ratio, an exponent for the thin method that is used in PERMAS topology optimization. We will introduce some manufacturing conditions like design variable filters, and of course we have to define the constraints and the optimization target. And the final point is to export new items. So these steps are illustrated in the next video. So we will extract the example from the topology optimization folder. It is the last one. It is a pretty new example because it consists of the new design constraint for buckling. This is the CI file. Because I want to show you how to complete the model, I will deactivate the second .dat file that contains the information about topology optimization. Then I will launch Whisper. So this is the cylindrical shell. Shift-W can be used to show you the elements and nodes. The first part is to create the optimization situation. So you have to connect the subsequent situations to the optimization situation. Then we will use a predefined element set for the design element. This is the entire model, the lower and upper bound, and the initial filling ratio is equal to 1. So we will start with a fully filled design element. We have different material models. We will use the power law and the variable fill type. The exponent is usually set to 3. And on the last page, we have to, on the second page, we can define manufacturing constraints, for example, a design variable filter. The average edge length is 10 millimeters, so we will use twice the average edge length, that means 20 millimeters. On the last page, we will define the constraints. We will start with the displacement constraint. You have to specify a name for this displacement constraint. It is called LP underscore W. W means the set direction of the displacement, and LP is the abbreviation for load point. This result is extracted from the static situation. There's already a node set called F. This is the load point, and this is also the design constraint point. Then you have to specify a lower and upper bounds, or only a lower bound in this case. And then you will save this constraint. The second constraint is a buckling constraint. We will use the load scale factor. And the first one, this is called LSF underscore 01, so load scale factor 1. And then we will use the buckling situation, and the first mode is used. And the lower bound for the bucklings, for the load scale factor is 2500. The constraint will be stored. And the final action is to define the objective function. As mentioned before, we will use the weight of this shell structure as our objective function. So in this case, we need no lower and upper bounds. And the checkbox is activated for the weight. So this is our objective function, and the objective target is to minimize the weight. So this is finished, and then we can export the new items that are created during the session. So this .dat file contains all the information that we have created during the usage of the topo wizard. The next point is to show you how to launch this example. Again, the starting point is our PERMAS control center. I will extract the example once again. I will edit the UCI file in order to create some additional results, so some intermediate results for the data combination that is used afterwards. And we will have a short look on the log file output. So the first step is to extract this example by using getExample. This is extracted to your working directory. So the next step is to edit the UCI file, because I want to generate some intermediate filling ratios. I will copy this export log inside the task loop. So that's it. So we have an additional export section in the task loop. The UCI file will be saved again. The next point is to start the Termath job, and then you will see some information. So the log file is directly available on the screen. You will see the different task loops. And at the end, after 36 iterations, the job is finished without errors. And computation time is less than 1 minute. Regarding the optimization, you will find some information about the convergence. It is achieved after 36 iterations. That is an important information for us, that the optimization is successfully solved. The last step is to post-process the results. So post-processing is the next point. I will show you how to import selected results. Permasgrad will be used for visualization of XY data. We will discuss some results, and then we will use Whisper for a data combination of filling ratios. So once the Permas job is completed, we can directly continue by open the model and results in Whisper. So we will select the intermediate results of the optimization. So all these HDF files will be imported. And before we do that, we open the Permas graph for visualization of XY data. First of all, we will use the objective function. So this is the weight of the shell structure. As you can see, the weight is minimized as wanted. This is the evolution. On the x-axis, you will see the number of iterations. You can store this picture in any format, like portable network graphics, JPEG, or PDF, whatever you prefer. You can modify the style. For example, you can modify the line widths, and so on. The next point is to display the relative constraint history that is used to check if there are any constraint violation. We have two constraints, one from the static analysis and one from the buckling analysis. The curves are in the interval between minus 100 and plus 100, so that means that the constraints are fulfilled, so there's no constraint violation. Again, you can modify the line widths, for example, and then you can save this for your report. So the next point is to start Whisper with all the intermediate results. We will use the visualization DB, but before, I would like to show you the mesh and the constraints again. So we will display the single point constraints. You can modify the size of the SPC symbols. And then you will go to the visualization DB results and data. That is a completely new and redesigned part of Whisper, where you are able to to post-process any kind of result. So one result is, for example, the nodal point force that can be visualized in vector mode. Then we will select the different filling ratios for a data combination. The derived data are available at the bottom. This can be visualized in Scala mode. And the last point is to animate the evolution of the filling ratio. And of course, you are able to store this as an animated GIF for your presentation. So this is the post-processing of results. And the last point is, thank you for listening. Many thanks to my colleagues from the development department. Without them, Canvas for Education wouldn't exist. Feedback, of course, is welcome. And I hope you are curious to use Canvas for Education. Please don't hesitate to contact us at any time or send us an email to info@intis.de. And please follow us on our YouTube channel and follow us on LinkedIn. Thank you very much for listening.
So Michael Klein will directly continue showing us some features in Contact.
So thank you very much, Niels, for all the details about PERMAS for Education, and thank you, Rolf, for your introduction. Now I try to share my screen. And wait for it. This is the last and short part of this presentation today, and it's a demonstration of the contact analysis. And this example is based on example CA6 that you will find in our examples manual. I have some main points I want to show to you. It's the pretension wizard, the contact analysis wizard, the load history assistant, and some editing in this new assistant, and a little bit of post-processing. On the right-hand side, you see the example that I know. Here's a drawing, and here you see the different parts that we have. We have a collar with a conical shaft inside and with a nut, and between the nut and the conical shaft, we will apply a pretension. And later on, after this assembly load, we have operating loads like a torque and a moment. On the left-hand side, you see the load history. There are some constant loads. There is friction applied in the contact areas with a relaxation step as step number two, the pretension as assembly load is applied at the beginning, and you see the two loads, the bending moment that is applied in two steps and the torque that is applied in one step directly. And in the last picture here, you see also that the collar is fixed on the outside, and you see again the contact regions here. The pretension region is green, and in red, the contact frictional regions. But let me switch directly to the live demonstration of this example. I have to open here the correct directory. I want to use the UCI, put it on the PERMAS for Edu icon, and I'm waiting for the launch of the control center. Here you directly see the UCI, but I want to open it with Whisper, and to avoid any time consume later on, I directly load the results here. So now I can start Whisper. waiting for Whisper now. The model is directly loaded. You see here the model I already showed to you in the drawings and on the slide. We can check now the different parts. They are here, the colors. I switch off some springs, and then I would like to check in the variant constraints the SPCs, and directly I can check them here on the outside of the collar. I see them. Okay, and let me go on to check the pretension in the pretension wizard under the wizards. I can open it here, and it's a pretension between nut and shaft. I just have to click on it, and it's directly visualized here in Whisper. And you can see it exactly with the pretension direction, and you can change, for example, the direction, but this is wrong, so I switch it back to the correct direction, commit it. So everything is directly visible, what I change here and what I check. In addition, the pretension load is also located here on the second tab. And you see here the first hint, we have a new load history assistant. It's not one tab of this wizard any longer. It's an additional load history assistant. I will come back later on this. Okay, after checking the pretension, I would like to check the contacts. Here I have several contacts. The shaft to collar contact I directly see here, it's highlighted. And if I go on here, I can also check the contact between washer and collar. Also, the different settings are located here. The different settings for the contact loading are found here. And again, just a button for the load history assistant that I will show to you later. Okay, when I go back, last point I want to check are the loadings. They are variant in the loading variant, and I have only concentrated loads. For that, I have to rotate my model and zoom a little bit inside, because the loads are applied here in the center of this MPC, and the loads are, as told before, in several load patterns. In load pattern 1003, there is a torque load, and it's shown here directly. And when I switch to the next load pattern and activate it, I see here also the bending load, how it's applied or where it's applied at the central node of this MPC. Okay, let's go on to check here now the load history that we have in a new assistant, and its load history. So it's located in the loading variant. Here the load history assistant is now. This is now a central point of loading, because it's very important for loading in permas. You see directly visualized here the complete load history. Now in version 18, it's available to have some comments or a description of the loads, and now it is possible to edit it. For this, I move it outside of this window and get an extra window, and by just clicking with the right mouse in the table, I can add, for example, a time step. This is added automatically at the end, but I would like to add a time step 3.5. So I edit it, and then it's located here. And what I want to have is a pretension loss to 80% of the pretension. And you see it is directly visualized here in the load history graph, but I don't want to have a continuous decrease from step 1 to step 3.5. I want to have the pretension loss just in this step. So I have to edit it again here. Instead of the continuation symbol, I input 1.0. So I have the correct behavior that I would like to have. If I close this, it's put it back here in the wizard, and here you see also the comments in top of the line. And if I want to input here a comment for, this is my step for loss of pretension, I can input it. And you will see all this information now also in the data file. If you save this model. The second tab of this assistant is are the result steps. I can add again by just picking with the right mouse button additional result steps. I would like to use equidistant steps, and I'm really interested in the time steps from 3.0 to 5.0 I take 0.1 steps, and again you see it's directly visualized here all the points where I would like to get results later on. Okay, for this assistant, I don't have to save anything. It's automatically saved, and I just close it. Now I can export the complete model, for example, as CA6 demonstration model, and export it. And if I like, then I can go back to PERMAS, this is, and start the job if I use the correct data file. But here I just show how it works, because I would like to go on with the already read in results, and here with the result and data. At first, I always want to check the displacements. Here I have the different time steps, so I can check it, but the movements are very small, so I change the scale factor to 10. So again, you see that the pretension is applied, and also if you like to see it here afterwards, after the pretension is applied later on, the torque and the bending are visible. Okay, in addition, now I turn around the model again. I want to check the contact forces as Kellyer values by removing some parts of the model before, because I want to see the contact area clearly. And by using the scalar lightening, I can see here the change of the contact force. But much more interesting than the normal force is the frictional force in this example. And to check it in more detail, I switch only on also on the vectors. They are a little bit too big, so I can scale them down. And let me move it a little bit around. And here you can see by moving through the time steps, I can study also with this education, the PERMAS for education in detail, for example, contact frictional results. Okay, this was my short live demonstration. So I come back to the slides and more or less to the last slide. So let me summarize the presentation of Niels and me about the PERMAS for education. So the most important point is we have essentially the same functionality as PERMAS and Whisper, and we think it's very good for self-studying and further training. We have now user forums available for self-support of the PERMAS for education users, and we provide a complete solution from the mesh to the post-processing with all steps that are necessary. Interesting for everyone is also that it's free for non-commercial use, and you just need a registration on the homepage of intus/edu. And one information is still missing, but I will provide it now. Oh, it's not possible with this mode. A moment, here is the last information I would like to give, because PERMAS for education is available from tomorrow. So you can start register tomorrow. So finally, I would like to thank you for your kind attention.